This video is for anyone interested in in-circuit test ICT with NoClean solder pastes. Glenn, one of the challenges since the inception of NoClean, as we know it, has been in-circuit testing. What are some of the new approaches in the incorporation is taking towards ICT?
Well, we have released a new product, but first let me talk about the fundamental way we do things today, all right? It has to do with the NoClean flux residue, all right? The more traditional approach is you have a soft, pliable residue, and when you make the ICT test insertion with the probe, you're able to penetrate that soft residue, you make electrical contact to the solder, you verify the circuit's good or not, the probe comes out, and you move on to the next test. And that works well for many applications, okay? However, inherently, a soft pliable residue sometimes will build up on a probe, all right? And when that occurs, over time, you build up so much that you're no longer able to make good insertion, especially on the first pass or at all. All right, so you end up with a yield degradation, false calls, et cetera, which means you might have to either chemically or mechanically clean those probes. So we've taken a different approach for our new product, the indium 10.2 HF, and we've done rather than the soft pliable residue, now we've moved on to a brittle fast break residue, so that as the probe comes down, the residue that's on the surface breaks away, allows the insertion to occur correctly, doesn't build up on the probe, so you have less residue buildup, and over time that you can still use that probe for many more insertions.
Fascinating topic. Glenn, where can we get more information on this?
As always, you can go to our website, indium.com, or you can send us an email directly at askus@indium.com.
Glenn, thank you very much.
Thank you. Good talking to you, Phil.